is pleased to bring you our feature presentation.
Fetches your papa's slippers, but different from any dog you've ever seen. Part mule, part elephant. You read about it in your leading periodical. You read about it in the dog National Chronicle. Yeah, you did, whether you remember or not. See the two-headed snake, two heads, two sets of fangs, two chances to be attacked by poisonous venom. They're all on the inside, folks. Let's go be going. It's showtime. Let's go be going. Only 25 cents. Just $0.25. Let's go be going.
Yes, sir, folks, and that was Cappy, the giant rat from Sumatra. Now, our next attraction, our fragile freak of nature, this five-legged cow found just 18 miles southeast of the nuclear testing site in Los Alamos, New Mexico. Yes, sir, one of nature's curious mistakes. Now, bunch up close, all of you, don't be scared. Because this thing over here is, believe it or not, folks, this is a two-headed snake. Take a look, coming close. Argued itself to death, it did. You married folks know what I mean. Check it out. Don't touch it. How about that? Yes. Yeah.
Now look, look there.
Night.
Night, Pixie.
Sleep tight.
You too, honey.
Yes, ma'am. I'd like to place a collect call to Mrs. Ida Crick in Tucumcari, New Mexico. Area code 505-555-7227.
And your name?
Just say Ellen.
All right.
Hello?
I have a collect call from Ellen. Will you accept the charges?
Come on, will you just accept the charges, please?
Yeah, I guess so.
Hi, Mother.
Why are you calling me, Pat?
Because I'm calling from a payphone.
Uh-huh.
I hear Cheryl crying. Why is she crying?
Yeah, well, you woke her up. You ought to know it's too late to call.
I miss her more at night when it's quiet. Mother, if she's up anyhow, let me talk to her, okay?
Just for a minute, just to hear her voice.
Listen to you. Am I meant to feel bad?
You cannot take care of the child.
Let's not have a fight, okay?
Listen, I didn't even want to accept the charges.
I'm pregnant. We'll say something.
You getting married again?
It's not like that.
No, I bet it isn't. You ever use the word no?
Don't be helpful or anything.
Listen, if you're trying to set me up to raise another one for you, you're getting nowheres fast.
Hey now, I didn't ask you to take Cheryl. You argued me into it.
We agreed on what was best for Cheryl now, didn't we, huh?
Yes, ma'am.
Uh-huh. You
want to
think about Cheryl? Don't come bringing your mess around here.
I swear to God, you really are something. At least last time you got yourself married.
What is wrong with you?
You got the morals of a cat.
Mother, fold it five ways and stuff it.
Nah, I'm not sure exactly what I'll do. Probably take off home for a little while.
Uh-huh.
I know this ain't exactly noticed.
What? I fall down dead in my shoes. I ever got that. Sorry to see you leave, though. Let me just see what I owe you.
Just enough to get me home. How you doing?
Fine, Pixie. You?
Good, thanks.
Bring a little water, Sylvie. Bring a little water now. Bring a little water. Every little once in a while, see me come running, see me coming now, see me come running, every little once in a while. Don't you see me coming? Don't you see me now? Don't you see me coming?
Hey there, Daddy. Surprise.
Yeah. You staying?
I thought maybe, yeah.
Well, I left the key. Ain't yet.
You got something for me to cook?
Expect so. Got a job around here or something?
Mm-mm. I'm knocked up.
Seen a doctor?
Nope.
Oh, maybe.
When you've been pregnant once, you know, Dad, you automatically know it. You just know. Doctor's cost.
Who's the fella?
Dad.
I'm just asking.
Just a guy, okay? Leave it be.
Does he know?
What for? Doesn't get me any less pregnant. Doesn't change a sweet thing. He's not interested, okay? What the hell am I gonna do?
How far on are you?
Couple months. I can't do it again. I got no money, I got no place to go, I got nothing. I don't want to have another baby.
I don't mind just staying here.
How could I keep it? I couldn't keep Cheryl.
I mean that.
If I had the money, I'd be raising Cheryl, don't you think?
You gonna give it up?
I can't give up another baby. Ever since Mother took Cheryl, every blessed morning, I wake up with this feeling like I need to take a breath. Right here. Like a physical pain.
I know the place.
And that's when I can see her, when I can talk to her. What can it possibly be like to have a kid of yours out there somewhere getting his butt kicked and you don't even know? At least I know Cheryl's happy with Mother.
How long you figure on staying?
Till you kick me out, I guess. Ladies happen to know someplace does abortions? It doesn't cost a whole lot.
When you go in there, you just gotta tell him you were raped, then he can do it.
No. Now, is that true?
I heard that if you've been raped, they can do it.
Now, there's supposed to be a place in Oak Cliff.
Ellen Russell.
Do you have a police report? It doesn't matter. The only abortion allowed in Texas is to save the mother.
You know what my life is like? I've been living in the back of a flatbed truck, sleeping on furniture throws. My clothes rolled up for a pillow. I can't take care of a child, and I have the money.
I'm going to give you the name of an attorney who arranges adoptions. You don't have to keep the baby.
I shouldn't have to go through this. I told you I was raped. It's not right. You could help me.
I'm trying, Ellen. But I'm not going to break the law. The lawyer's name is Daryl Horwood.
You never had a baby. You don't know what it's like. It's the hardest thing in the world to give up a child.
I just can't do it.
Thank you. hate having to ask you this, but the prospective parents, the adoptive parents, they always want to know if the father is the ethnic background of the father.
You mean, is he white? Yeah, he's white.
Because there's no call for minority babies.
They gotta have them, they gotta keep them.
Oh, too true, but that's the scope of it. Everybody yammers about welfare, mother.
Hey, I'm not on welfare.
No, I didn't mean to say...
I'm pregnant, I'm not trash.
I don't call anybody trash.
I actually tried to go to a guy. I went to a guy, you know, in Oak Cliff.
On Vincent? Oh, girl.
Hey, I just can't figure any way out of this. Either I get myself cut up on a tabletop or I end up carrying a baby for 9 months that I can't keep. All because I made a mistake. I bet you know some doctor. You must have heard about some good doctor.
No. All my contacts are doctors who won't. What about going to a state where abortion is legal? New York, California.
On what? On my good looks?
Maybe you ought to try to change the laws here in Texas.
Oh, yeah. Send me to law school, why don't you?
No, because I know a couple of lawyers, women lawyers, who are working on a constitutional case to allow abortion, but they need somebody like you to be a plaintiff. You could sue the District Attorney of Dallas, Mr. Henry Wade, for enforcing state laws that prevent you from having an abortion. If you win, abortion will be legal in Texas. It'll be safe.
You saying I'll be able to have an abortion?
You want to meet him, at least?
Okay, fine. Introduce me.
Kitchen stuff.
How much for the chili set?
50 cents. Bounce a little bit.
I don't know.
Feels good, huh? Lie back. Don't be shy.
Isn't
that
nice?
Sir, telephone.
Okay, you know, that's going to be the cheapest guest bedroom you're ever going to find. Excuse me. Hey, babe, who is it?
It's Linda.
Really, is she here in Austin?
No, in Dallas.
Give me that. Hey, Linda, how are you?
Catch a plane, lady. There's someone I want you to meet.
Like who?
Like a possible plaintiff.
You're kidding. No, that's great news. Wait. Hey, Ron!
Yeah.
Well, we're going to try, but we can't promise you.
More coffee, ladies?
Yes, please.
Thank you.
Well, at least it might keep other women from having to go through what we're going through now.
You know what I'm going through?
No. No, I don't. But we've all sat there with the calendar in our laps, going from month to month, asking ourselves, am I late, counting up the days.
And praying.
I even went out and bought a pound and a half of peanuts. Woman at the counter said, honey, you're pregnant. I said, don't I know? I went home and I drank down a bottle of castor oil with the peanuts. I'm here to tell you, you ever wondering yourselves, doesn't work. All it did was make me sick like you wouldn't believe. I don't know a damn thing left to do.
Well, it shouldn't be any of the DA's business. It's so personal.
Personal to me, that's for damn sure. And I gotta tell you, I'm thinking about myself here, you know, because I've always been a loner. I don't mess with nobody because I don't want nobody messing with me.
Why'd you come to meet us tonight?
Free meal?
I don't think so.
What sign are you?
Aquarius. What, is that bad?
Well, we could get along. So, you ladies are my last hope, you know. Would I have to stand up in court and everybody know me?
No. We can use a fictitious name on the complaint. You wouldn't even have to appear.
Because I don't want people laughing at me.
We can call you Jane Roe.
Like John Doe. Jane. Huh. Never thought of myself as a Jane before. My dad finds out he's never gonna understand. He's Jehovah's Witness. I'm the renegade of the family. Though I believe in God, of course.
Mother. My mother gave me hell the rest of her natural life, she knew. She's good at that. Real good.
So do you want to do this?
Isn't that what I just been telling you? My stars.
Statement of facts that you're supposed to sign on your oath.
The affidavit.
Yeah. Which goes to the federal district court here in Dallas. We're asking the U.S. courts to declare the Texas law unconstitutional.
Basically, the affidavit just states that you're not married, that you're still pregnant.
Oh, I'm definitely still pregnant. Now, where do y'all put in that part about how I was raped?
Well, actually, Ellen, we decided not to use that. I mean, even if Texas law were to allow an abortion in the case of rape, it just wouldn't be good enough.
Might be good enough for me.
It would be impossible to prove without witnesses, without a police report.
And we really want to get a ruling on a broader basis.
Like whether or not a woman has the right to make up her own mind. And not just in the case of rape or incest or if your life is in danger.
Contraceptives fail. Your luck runs out.
Tell me.
If you can't take care of a baby or you're not ready to, it shouldn't matter what the reasons are. You shouldn't have to bear a child and give it up to strangers just because the state of Texas says so.
When's this hearing? What's the date?
Looks like it'll be early May, although it's not set yet.
Oh, now hold up. This is March. May. May's 2 months away, 2 more months.
Assuming we win.
Is that gonna be too long for you? You have to tell us, Ellen.
No, I know you're working just as fast as you can. It's just every day's like a month. So, you got a pen? Where do I sign this thing?
Wait, I think you should read this through first.
I trust you. We're the Three Musketeers.
Do me a favor, read this through anyway. Yeah, I can. I can handle all of that from Austin if you'll do the filings from here.
I've stuck you with more of the work.
I've got the time, you know.
You could go into private practice yourself if you'd move out of Austin. It's too dinky a town. There are never going to be enough jobs.
And just leave my husband behind in law school so I can get ahead. Nice, Linda.
Do you believe she was raped?
Wasn't the most convincing story I've ever heard.
I thought you handled that very deftly.
Well, once she told the doctor, what else could she say with that sound like a liar? Thank you.
Not that we've exactly laid the whole truth on her. Maybe she ought to know neither one of us has ever gone to court before.
We've never argued before, that's all.
Oh, well, that's all.
Listen, you know all about federal procedures. You were in district court every single day when you clerked for Sarah Hughes.
It's gonna be very weird arguing in front of her.
Is she that tough on attorneys?
Only if they screw up. Bye-bye.
Bye, honey. Thank you.
Get the injunction on the anti-war sit-in, Joe?
Which one, yesterday's or today's?
Not another one.
Yeah, the recruiting office as of 10 o'clock this morning. Oh,
good morning, gentlemen. Here they are.
Hey, about injunction.
The judge was surprised they hadn't gone to fish.
Fair amount. Nothing over 8 inches, but bad. Who goes fishing for the fish?
Well, Bob does.
Gentlemen, if there's no other news, I have a whole new batch of habeas cases up for assignment. Looks like about one each.
Oh, my.
Not you, Jay Bird. I'm saving you.
Uh-oh.
I know how much you enjoy defending the constitutionality of our state laws.
Mm-hmm.
Again? Which is it this time?
One Miss Jane Roe has sued Mr. Henry Wade for upholding the law on abortion.
On top of it, I have to go to Dallas. Wonderful.
You'll make half a day in court and be home.
That a promise?
Which amendments did you cite in the complaint?
Let's see. First, fourth, fifth, ninth, 14th.
You didn't fool around, did you?
We threw in everything.
You know, you might want to cite U.S. versus Vuitch and Griswold versus Connecticut in the oral argument.
I've been reading that Vuitch case. You think so, really?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Women's right to privacy.
All right.
You know, if the founding fathers...
Oh, God, the founding fathers.
If they believed in a fundamental right to abortion, they would have put it in the Constitution.
Except abortion was legal when the Constitution was written under English law. The states didn't start to pass anti-abortion laws till the 19th century, when medicine was so bad. They're just trying to protect women. Would you like some more coffee?
Thank you.
Women have been having abortions for 5,000 years in every society on the face of the earth, Professor. It's an incredibly difficult choice. But we do what we need to do.
You don't have any children, do you?
No, sir, I don't. Not yet.
Well, I do. And you can call it protoplasm all you like. You're still talking about the end of a life. Doesn't that bother you a little bit?
Women are dying. That's the end of a life. You know as well as I do, the law doesn't stop abortions. It just makes them dangerous.
You're gonna lose, Sarah. You're too emotional.
Well, then you got nothing to worry about.
He takes it personally.
So do I.
Well, could he at least sing?
Oh, could he sing? Oh.
God, men can be so sweet and so nasty. Same once. Now, why is that?
Ellen, you don't have good luck with men, honey.
Tell me. You know, when Roy and I got married, I didn't let on I was pregnant.
And when he found out, he beat me clear from the kitchen to the living room and halfway back again. Said it wasn't his. Couldn't have been nobody else's. I said, this is your baby. I ain't done a thing I'm ashamed of. As soon as he went to work the next day, I sold his clothes and stuff, and I split on the son of a bitch.
Shh. That's Cheryl's daddy you're talking about.
I think about him sometimes. You know what I'd like? I'd like to do something, and he'd hear about me and feel bad about how he behaved. I'd be somebody, and he'd still be pumping gas.
I could say that about everybody I ever knew in high school.
I can't even find the guy. Maybe if he just paid child support, I could have kept her, but I had to work. I tried to sneak her to the job, you know. I never could afford a sitter. I put a playpen in the washroom. I got fired regular. Thank the Lord for mother. She took Cheryl from me, but she's raising her fine, so what can I do? I sign the damn papers, I listen to my mother. I fall asleep at night hearing my mother.
You can't think about it all the time. Get over here.
She would have liked the carnival. She would have liked the ponies. We had a couple of real sweet ponies.
It's me. It's Ellen.
It's Jane, okay?
Oh, hi. Was that your sweetie? You weren't asleep, were you? Oh, hey. I'm not bothering you, am I?
No, no, not at all. Not at all. We're still up feeding.
How are you?
Me and my pregnant self? It's fine, considering.
Well, have you changed your mind? You want to come to court tomorrow? I'm too busy trying to find a job. Hey, I'd love to be discovered, but not as Jane Rowe. I don't even want to hear what my friends would say. I like having friends.
And forget my dad. I'd be on the street. Maybe not, but
the way my luck breaks, who needs to find out, you know what I mean? The hearing won't be about luck. Then I won't wish any. Call me after, because we don't talk all that much. I know, I've been, I did try to call you last week, and I tried calling you twice the week before. No, I must have been out. I do that a lot lately. But will you call me after the hearing? We won't find out anything for a couple of weeks. Ellen? Right here and counting down. Are you all right? You must be working hard. I just want to make sure that we win this. Hey, I got all the confidence in the world. What's your sweetie's name? Oh, that's my husband, Ron. He sounds cute.
He is cute.
Well, then you better get yourself off the phone, girl.
Okay. Good night, Ellen.
Night, Sarah.
If it pleases the court, my name is Sarah Weddington. The only justification which the state has advanced at this point for the abortion statute is that of protecting what they term the life of the unborn child. It is almost impossible to define a point at which life begins, or perhaps even at which it ends. Certainly, life in its most general matter exists in the sperm. It exists in the ova, without the state showing a bit of interest.
Do you think that the present statute, bad as you say it is, shows any compelling interest on the part of the state to regulate abortion?
Not as it's written. It's so broad that it denies abortion to all those women whom I believe under the right to privacy of the Ninth Amendment have a constitutional right to abortion. Since the four recent cases which deal with the abortion statute have unanimously recognized the right to privacy.
What four cases are you talking about?
United States versus Vuitch.
I don't read Vuitch that way. I think it was stricken down on the basis that it was vague.
Excuse me, Your Honor. Quoting from that opinion, there has been an increasing indication in the decisions of the United States Supreme Court that a woman's liberty and right of privacy extends to family, marriage, and sex matters, and may well include the right to remove an unwanted child, at least in the early stages of pregnancy.
If the state had to pay for a number of these abortions, would the state have a compelling interest in keeping the number down from an economic point of view?
The state would have more of an interest in not making welfare payments to many of those children and their parents when they are later produced than it would in denying basic constitutional rights of women. Thank you.
Your Honors, I'm Jay Floyd, Assistant Attorney General for the State of Texas. I cannot perceive how this would fall under religion, speech, or press of the First Amendment.
We agree with you in that. Go on to the Ninth Amendment, and what about vagueness?
They have raised the question of privacy, the fundamental right to choose, of the woman to choose whether she will bear a child, which goes to her privacy. Now, I will point out here that in the Bellis case, and then in the Vuitch case, the court went further than the right of privacy and stated that the critical issue is whether the state has a compelling interest in the regulation. Now, Your Honors, there have been many, many arguments advanced as to when an embryo becomes a human being.
I don't see how that's getting you anywhere.
But the point is that the state's interest may be in whether or not murder occurs if this embryo is considered a human being.
You mean if the embryo is considered a human being at the moment of pregnancy?
Yes, Your Honor. Now, I'm not advocating this. I'm saying there's some controversy in regard to this. But the life of every person starts somewhere. Every person in this room at one time was the most primitive form of embryo. The state believes it has the right to protect life that is in being at whatever stage it may be in being. And if there is no absolute fact as to when life occurs, then this becomes, I think, a legislative problem, not a judicial one. Thank you.
Thank you, counsel. Case is now submitted.
Vote on the water rights and left.
Did you ever imagine you'd get somewhere?
Liberal bitch.
Like claiming the murder statutes are unconstitutional.
Hey, Bob.
How are you, Senator?
Shame about the district court. World's just going crazy.
Yes, sure is.
I feel like I said. And then we had that conference.
Police court had the good sense not to issue an injunction.
Now, that was a compromise, so they could vote for abortion without having to allow it.
We'll win the appeal.
How can any intelligent person feel sorrier for the woman than for the baby? Her life or the baby's life, all right, sure, it's in the law, but her peace of mind? That's not valuable enough. It's not worth another human life. It can't be if we want to keep calling ourselves civilized.
So we'll go for broke.
There's no in between. Not for us, not for them.
Just give me the English version, please, okay?
It means you're not going to be able to get an abortion, Ellen. I wish this were different.
Abortion is now legal in the state of Texas. Except any doctor who actually performs one can go to jail. It makes no sense. I know it. The court didn't issue an injunction in order to enforce their decision. And Henry Waite has already said he's going to keep on prosecuting any doctors that he catches until the appeal's decided.
The state's appealing the whole decision to the next court up the line. But we are going straight to the U.S. Supreme Court, and we are asking for injunctive relief.
To stop Waite.
Well? How long does that take?
A year. Maybe two.
You mind explaining to me how it is that you won and I lost?
Ellen, we warned you that this might happen way back when we first met in that coffee shop. We did not talk you into this. We did not promise you that we could get you an abortion.
You let me think that, and you let me hope, and now I gotta have this baby, and I can't even find a job? I'm sorry. What the hell? It's probably too late for me anyway.
I'm getting a ton of helpful calls. Even a professor from the law school offered his services on the appeal.
That's a surprise. They usually come out on the other side of these questions.
Had to be one of their professors. That's where they both win. Of course, I wasn't going to ask. You want to see a letter? From the Brooklyn Women's Club.
Boy, you're in trouble.
They say until I have a uterus transplant and have an abortion or a child, I can't know anything about it.
Jaybird, wait till they find out you're a confirmed bachelor. Maybe I should have thought about that before I gave you the case.
I thought maybe I'd write back and say I may not have a uterus, but I've definitely been a baby. Joke, Bob.
So that's the strategy, huh? You're going to concentrate on the humanity of the fetus.
If it's human when it's born, then we go in reverse, take it back into the womb, minute by minute, all the way back to conception. Pick out the minute when it stops being human.
You got to be careful. You don't want to find yourself arguing that the state of Texas selectively murders people by allowing abortion at all. Flowers.
Yeah, Bob, this is Harold King.
I think this one's my favorite.
I'm gonna get copies made of all of these, send them off to my daddy.
You think he'll appreciate that?
He's proud of me, especially since the Methodist Church came out for a woman's right to choose, being Methodist and all.
Cheryl. We are really starting to get some support.
You see any money coming in? It's just gonna be you and me, Linda.
No. You're gonna start getting a lot of help now. You wait and see. I can't keep up with the case, sir.
Don't. I don't want to hear this.
There aren't enough hours in the day. You know what private practice is like.
No, I don't.
Well, then I'll tell you. I'm the only woman in the firm. I worked hard to get this job. I'm not gonna screw it up. I'm not ditching on you, Sarah. I just have to take the back seat, that's all.
How am I supposed to do all this by myself?
What about Ron? He's smart and able.
What about Ron? He's studying for the bar. Linda, this is our case.
I can't.
Thank you. I can dance a little faster, Dad.
Maybe I can.
I love to dance. One thing I was always good at was dancing. Seems like dancing used to just make everything nicer. Oh, hey, you remember when I was in Rodgers and Hammerstein's South Pacific?
You were?
Yeah, I was. You weren't around by then, I guess.
Can't always be with your children. You know that. It's all in the circumstances.
Well, you're going to have to take my word for it. But I was good. I was another Greta Garbo. I was going to set the world on its axis. I was going to be somebody. Pretty funny, huh?
Ellie, you ever think about keeping it?
No.
I wanted to. Maybe there's a way we could manage it.
To bring up this baby?
I'm just thinking, this is my grandchild.
Accidents causing accidents.
It's your decision. It's up to you. You got to do what you think is best for you. I only meant if you wanted to keep it.
I had the means to raise a child, I'd go right after Cheryl now, wouldn't I? In a New York minute. Except I don't, and I can't. I'm just trying to save myself now, and maybe I'm already a lost cause, and it's going to get worse. But I can't think about keeping this baby. And I can't think about giving it up. I'm squeezed between a rock and a hard place, Daddy. Hell, I'm squished. Hey, Joyce.
Did you try Denny's?
Yes, ma'am, I did. And Sambo's and Howard Johnson's and the Colonial Kitchen and the Pancake House. I'm a good waitress. I could work the grill in the back out of sight. Nobody'd have to see me. I wouldn't be a handicap.
Why don't you see if we got an opening after you've had your baby?
You advertised.
When you do?
October.
Well, now that's not so long, honey.
All right, regarding the briefs from the outside, here's where we are. Planned Parenthood, the League of Women Voters, National Organization of Women, the YWCA.
The YWCA is going to convince the U.S. Supreme Court to take the case? Oh, man.
We're thinking cumulative here, J.R.
Hi.
Hey.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, y'all.
Hey, Ron.
I also put a call in to the American Public Health Association and the National Welfare Rights Organization.
Okay. Also working with the National Abortion Action Coalition. But what we really could use is a good medical brief. Now, who do we know on the faculty of a med school?
To help us coordinate?
Well, let's not forget that there are 30 other cases just like this one trying to get to the Supreme Court.
Yeah, but don't you think ours would be the best test? I mean, considering that Texas has the most restrictive law in the country.
Assuming the court wants a test.
We're going to assume that.
Well, now, my brother teaches at med school in Galveston if you need a contact.
Great. What's his name?
Brian.
Let's get real here. Is he cute? Is he married?
I can't believe you said that.
Everything always have to be so heavy around here.
I'm still waiting on the answer.
Good girl. All right. Now push. Push. Come on. Come on. Push. You're almost there now. Now, bear down. Come on. Bear down. Really bear down. Come on. You can do it. Come on. Give me a good big push now. Come on. That's a girl. Come on. Come on. Oh, right. Oh, we got it. Good girl.
Is it all right? All 10 fingers and toes.
It's just perfect.
Boy or girl?
Fine, healthy baby.
Boy or girl?
You don't want to know any more than that, Ellen.
Let me see just for a second, okay? Just a peek. Oh.
Thank you.
can't drink, that's for damn sure. If you hadn't come around pretty soon, I was going to call the doctor. Even though they probably wouldn't have been much help, even in the army, they just let us sleep it off.
My head.
I got some aspirin ready for you. Mm. Right here. You'll be.
What time is it?
It's a bit after four. I took the day off. You sure gave me a start finding you on the floor like that.
It didn't occur to me.
Whoever thinks they're gonna drink themselves under the table? Literally, in your case.
Oh, Daddy.
What was that lethal combination you ingested anyhow?
Not lethal enough, apparently. I was too wrecked to remember.
I used to have nights like that, where I took to clean living.
You used to go on what?
I wasn't no wallflower.
Till I showed up.
Set me on the path to rectitude. I'm not complaining.
Well, you're in luck, pal. I got a case of the itchy feet coming on. I can feel it. About time, don't you think?
We're doing fine. You don't have to go.
No, I know.
You can come back anytime you want.
The Supreme Court's agreed to hear Roe versus Wade. Read it.
Oh, man, congratulations.
I never thought they'd take this case.
Jaybird's going to the Supreme Court.
Boy, I can feel that in my stomach. You gotta spring me some time, Bob. I can't handle my whole caseload in the brief, too.
Yeah, I'm creeping on out of you. A few more cases, won't hurt you. Looks like we got some things to talk about, son.
That's great, Jay.
Hey, you. Hey, you.
Well, hey there, girl.
Surprise.
You need a place to crash.
How'd you get?
Well, you know the house.
Yeah, I do.
I'm late. I gotta run.
Where are you going?
I gotta go paint.
Hey, boy dog.
I'll be back around 5.
Okay, I'll see y'all around supper time.
All right.
Hello.
Ellen, this is Sarah Weddington.
How'd you get this number? Did you get it from my dad? You didn't tell him who you are, did you?
No, of course not. Just said I was a friend.
What you calling about, Sarah?
Well, I have some good news. Roe versus Wade is going to the Supreme Court. We made it all the way to the top.
Well, good for Jane Roe. That's great, that is. Doesn't do me a damn bit of good, but I'm glad to hear about it. You didn't have to bother calling me, though. I'd have seen it in the newspaper. I read the paper, you know. You there?
Yeah, I'm here. How are you doing?
Well, I had a baby. You probably lost track when I was due.
Did everything go all right?
Baby was healthy. Don't know anything more than that. Never gonna know anything more than that. tried to kill myself.
God, Ellen.
Not too successfully, as you can tell. I just don't have good luck. I must have mentioned that.
That is not funny.
Sure it is. It's hysterical.
Ellen, I want you to listen to me for a minute. You did not have to go through hell for nothing. We have a chance to make a law here.
This is your case. We wouldn't have even had a case if it wasn't for you.
You know how many people in America are going to thank Jane Roe for winning this thing?
Except I had a baby. I gave up a baby. Nothing was going to change that part.
Are you sorry you got involved?
No. No, I'm not. It's the first time I ever did anything for anybody else. I gotta go, Sarah.
All right, well, I'll be in touch with you.
But thanks for calling me, and I mean that.
Well, wait a minute.
Okay, bye-bye now. Bye.
Who was that?
Some chick hustling insurance.
You gonna brood all night?
Just wish you could have met her. She's not like anybody else I've ever known.
Well, you have led a notoriously sheltered life, girl.
Ryan, I know that you are serious about this. You are committed.
But.
Well, she had to go through it. Linda and I did not have to have that baby.
That's a given.
You don't seem very concerned about the client.
Well, no, I'm not. There's nothing you can do for her anymore. The case is what counts.
I know that. Don't you think that I know that? I was trying to tell her how important this case is, and right in the middle of it, I started to think about that. I started to think about all the women, all of them, millions of women.
You spooked?
I've only gone to court once.
Well, that's about to change.
I can't mess this up.
Concentrate on the process.
Okay.
Secrets in the applewood chips. Hides the taste of the lighter fluid.
Did you know that by the end of the third month, even though there's no real brain working yet, that a fetus can move? Suck its thumb?
Jay, you're gonna have to.
You know about salt water injections?
Yeah.
Woman has a little trouble making up her mind. She waits four and a half months. By then, it's too big to scrape up, so they inject a little saline. You have yourself a stillbirth 12 hours later.
Jay, you're not just working on an argument now. This is really getting to you.
I keep telling myself that I can't afford to get emotionally involved, but this is the biggest case I'm ever going to have, Bob. I'm not talking about my career. Children's lives are depending on me. I have to win it. This is the one I have to win.
How come with this long list of folks on our side, it's all moral support and no cash?
I know that it seems like that, but you have to consider the types of groups we're dealing with here. Now, you know everybody's spread very thin.
Well, what about a few more garage sales?
All right. Does anybody have anything left to sell?
No.
I didn't think so. Thank you.
You could probably pull a grant from the Institute for Constitutional Law. They have a whole staff of lawyers and researchers and all that crap.
In New York?
Mm-hmm.
Well, he's just trying to get rid of me.
Not that I'd notice the difference.
They're going to want to take over the case.
Well, we seriously could use the help.
Nobody's going to push Sarah out of the way, Jerry.
They'd be too thrilled if you brought him in. This is only the biggest case in America right this minute.
Just to help me write the brief, you mean?
Whatever you need, hon.
Sarah can write the brief.
Well, maybe she doesn't think so. Am I wrong?
I already said I could use the help.
Well, there you go.
Good night, Jer.
Good night, Ron.
Good night.
Thanks, Janet.
Thank you.
Drive carefully.
I will.
Okay. What the hell was all that about?
All what?
Don't start with me, Ron. You know what I'm talking about.
You are so defensive.
I am not defensive. You were all over me out there.
So much for an honest, frank exchange of opinion.
But you don't have to go so far out of your way as to undercut me. That is all I am saying.
You know, I wouldn't mind an occasional conversation just now and then that wasn't all about you and your feelings and your case and your client.
Oh, what? I'm not paying enough attention to you? Don't you know that this is the most important thing I'm ever going to get to do?
Sarah, I don't want to fight, okay?
Well, I don't either.
Okay. I know that you're tired.
Spare me the preacher's daughter. Don't be nice to me.
Fine.
How about this one? A sewing machine operator for a notions manufacturer. Small shop.
Yeah, sweatshop.
It's just work. I just want to earn a living. I don't want to have to think. I don't want to talk. I don't want to think, don't you see?
You could come work with me.
Don't do me any more favors, okay?
Why don't you just get on with it?
I'm trying. I really am.
Yeah? Because I can't tell. I mean, you don't do anything. You don't go anywhere. You don't see anybody. You sit here with the shades down all day long.
I'm watching TV.
I mean, I've been listening to you read these damn want ads for 2 solid weeks. You keep picking out the lousiest possible jobs, except they're never quite lousy enough.
You can learn a lot from TV.
Okay, I'll mind my own business. I just think you ought to stop beating up on yourself.
Hey, watch where you're walking, darling.
Hey, baby, don't knock me over. Don't knock me over.
Oh, no, don't scare me. Don't scare me. No.
Oh, my goodness. You're so big. You're so big. I can't believe it. What are you doing?
Hey, Mother.
I don't suppose you thought to call first.
I was afraid of what you'd say. Look at you. You are such a pretty thing. Don't get nervous, Mother. I'm not staying.
Look at these 2 little girls. Which of the dresses do you like the
Look
best?
Look what I got, some cookies for a pretty girl. She's gonna pick her own cookie here. Come on. All right. Come here, baby. Let me open it for you. Right.
She's gotten so big. I just can't get over it.
I know. Well, it's been a long time since you paid us a visit.
You moved to New Mexico.
Maybe you use that tone with your father, but don't talk to me like that, Ellen. I mean, I am allowed to make a simple statement.
You're always picking at me.
I haven't even mentioned it. I don't even know if you had a boy or a girl.
Oh, Mother, please don't.
That was my grandchild. Don't I have a right to even know?
I don't even know.
Listen, Ellen, I'm going to give you a piece of advice. Although you have never in your entire life ever listened to me, and there's no reason on God's good earth why you should do it now. But I think you ought to start thinking about having your tubes tied. You ready for a nap now, honey?
Oh, not yet. No, I haven't even seen her.
And whose fault is that? Come on, honey, nap time. Say bye.
I'd rather have a story.
Oh, we're going to read you a story. Give me her little purse, would you?
Okay.
One of those books?
Why couldn't you have been as nice to me as you are to her?
She's a better little girl than you were. You want to put her down?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll see you real soon.
I could ask you to stay to dinner.
But you won't.
I don't think so.
You never do. I love you too, Mama.
The noise doesn't get you, the heat will. Is it like this in Dallas, the heat?
Austin.
Austin, Dallas, Austin. Same difference.
Terry, I thought you said you're already working on the brief. I thought you said that by the time I got here, all we'd have to do is staple it together.
We haven't had the time yet, Sarah. Yours isn't the only case we're handling, you know. We have civil rights cases, free speech cases, civil liberties cases.
They're not all going to the Supreme Court, though.
The filing deadline is 2 months away.
It goes quick.
Well, you can do the research right here. You won't need any help with that. And when you get to the drafting, we'll write the basis for you. Won't be hard. Hey, I've been there before. I've argued in front of the court. We're all right.
Well, guess I'll start in the library.
Holler if you need anything.
When the night comes falling around me, and life's just a heavy load, when it seems like there's no one to believe in, I keep holding on. No, I won't let go. 'Cause I've looked in the eyes of a stranger,
Terry. How's your section coming?
Working on it.
Well, I hope you're working on the end. Filing deadline's 13 days away. Now, come on, talk to me.
I'm stuck.
I don't want to hear that.
I know I said we'd write that section for you.
You even picked it. The precedence of the mother's rights over the rights of the fetus was the crucial part. That's what you said! Only you didn't want to trust it to amateurs from west of the damn Hudson.
I never said...
You thought it!
Well, what do you want me to do, Sarah?
Are you kidding?
We're all on the same side.
Getting hard to tell. Excuse me.
South Vietnamese forces have been steadily retreating since two communist divisions launched a major offensive earlier this month. Advancing under a heavy cloud cover, the communists have been almost immune from America.
Hello.
South.
Right, it's me.
Oh, hi, babe.
They haven't done a damn thing. And they're not gonna either. I'm going down here. I'm losing this. I need your help. Do you think that you could leave the practice for a bit and come out east?
I'll call you from the airport.
Okay.
Love you. Bye-bye. Now, what about this? What about using the 14th Amendment? All persons born or naturalized. Born. You get it? Sarah, we don't celebrate days of conception, do we? No, it's birthdays. And you want to talk tax exemptions? Let's bring the feds in here. The IRS doesn't give you a tax break until the year the child is born. Does this sound ridiculous? Is this just the caffeine talking?
Keep going.
Well, miscarriages don't need death certificates or get funerals.
How about the Keeler case?
California.
Would have gone the same way under Texas law. She's almost a full term when her husband beat her up.
She fractured his skull, didn't he?
And he still couldn't be found guilty.
Well, not of homicide, no.
Because he didn't kill a human being.
Which has to be born. They're gonna laugh at this.
No, not when Floyd is using the Fifth Amendment and the Due Process of Law Clause to try and claim equal protection for persons not yet born. I mean, what are the two rock bottom issues here, huh? Is there a fundamental right of privacy?
Well, you wrote that part as good as it gets.
And does the state have a compelling interest to override it? Now, how interested can the state be when it doesn't bother about any other fetal rights? And if a fetus isn't a person, even under Texas law, then Floyd's argument's in trouble.
Let's hope.
They got 29 separate organizations assigned briefs for them.
Like who?
And that doesn't include a group of 178 named physicians.
Yeah, but who are the big guns?
I was sorry to see the American College of Obstetrics and Gynecology on the list.
Looking out for themselves, the other ones getting prosecuted.
Of course, that doesn't mean they all agree. I can put together a group on our side.
Any other surprises?
A lot of women's professional groups, abortion groups, a bunch of liberal churches, no? About who you'd expect.
They're pulling out all the stops, aren't they?
They need to. They don't even have standing. Jane Roe isn't pregnant anymore.
You're gonna argue it's moot.
I want to give the court every possible chance not to have to decide this. Because if they do try to rule, they're gonna have to choose between a woman and her baby.
I didn't think the court was gonna let both of us argue.
Well, we can both sit at the council table.
What are we supposed to wear?
Something dark and respectful. Hey, guess who's coming to the practice court session tomorrow?
Terry Bowman.
As you know.
Yeah, he's a grandstander. Sure, he'll be there. You gonna be nice to him?
As nice as he is. You know, every time I start to think about this Supreme Court, I get so nervous I start to sweat. I feel like the whole movement's counting on us. And I'm not exactly sure how we ended up out here in front.
You're gonna be great.
I'm gonna be great. Yeah, I'm gonna be great. It'll be fine. Starting to trickle down my side. Well, it is. I'm really glad you're here.
Are you arguing, Mrs. Weddington, that it was the intention of the Founding Fathers to allow abortion on demand when they wrote the Constitution?
Your Honor, the court has said that life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness are fundamental to the people. And since women must be included in this category...
Don't get sarcastic with them, Sarah.
Let her finish.
I think in as far as... I think one of the purposes of the Constitution was to guarantee to the individual the right to determine the course of their own lives. And the choice of whether or not to continue an unwanted pregnancy has to be considered one of those rights.
Don't stop. Don't stop. It's not an interview.
I was just taking a breath, Terry.
When you only have 30 minutes to make your entire argument, you can't afford to lose any time. Now, the justices start interrupting right from the top. Whenever there's a pause, get in your next point. And when the white light goes on, you've got 5 minutes. When the red light goes on, close your mouth. You're done.
Even now, Your Honor, under Texas law, it is not a crime for a woman to abort herself at any stage in her pregnancy, as Woodrow versus the state held. I'm sorry,
I'm gonna make a suggestion here. Mm-hmm. What about putting in a litigator for the argument?
Well, what do you call me?
You're a fine lawyer, Sarah. I just met someone with a little more experience. I mean, how about Terry? He's won a Supreme Court case. He can handle himself.
Thanks.
No, I'd be happy to do the argument if you want me to, Sarah.
This is a woman's case. It's a woman's issue, and a woman should argue it.
Wait a minute. You don't think men are affected by this? Men are involved. It's a human issue.
Why don't we ask the client? It's her case. I think she has the right to choose who's going to represent her.
There's only 7 justices instead of 9, so let's add it up.
Douglas and Marshall, you can forget they're hardcore.
But we can probably count on the Nixon guys, Berger and Blackmun.
The Minnesota twins.
Not that they always agree.
That's 2-2.
Stewart dissented on Griswold. I can't believe he turned around and voted for Roe. How do you read Brennan? He's a Catholic.
Yeah, but look at his opinions. He's very strong on individual rights. Even Stephen?
White. He's been drifting toward our side.
Not enough for us to count on yet.
But that's the swing vote, looks like.
Weddington goes first. Depending on how White reacts to her, you could adjust your argument for him. You're good on your feet.
Hey, Sarah.
Hi.
You find the stump all right?
Just where you said it'd be.
What can I get you on the house?
You got any coffee?
Oh, I take my break in a couple minutes.
Okay.
So, how come you trying to make this other guy sound so good?
Look, I just want you to have all the facts, all the information. I want you to know that you have a choice.
You really think I'd fire you?
I don't even know him.
Would you like to meet him?
Not particularly. You my lawyer, you still my lawyer, you argue.
Good.
Sarah, I want to tell you something. I wasn't ever raped.
I'm glad to hear that.
I just wanted you to know.
Thanks.
Man, there isn't a single soul here on our behalf. Don't run.
Well, honey, about time.
Just kidding, Jay Bird.
All right. Good. Morning. Morning.
Morning.
This minute, I'm glad it's you and not me.
The Honorable, the Chief Justice, and the Associate Justices of the Supreme Court of the United States. Oyez, oyez, oyez. All persons having business before the Honorable, the Supreme Court of the United States, are admonished to draw near and give their attention, for the court is now sitting. God save the United States and this honorable court.
We will hear arguments in number 18, Roe against Wade. Mrs. Weddington, you may proceed whenever you're ready.
Mr. Chief Justice, and may it please the court, this case is a direct appeal from a decision from the United States District Court for the Northern District of Texas. The court declared the Texas abortion law to be unconstitutional for two reasons. First, that the law was impermissibly vague, and second, that it violated a woman's right to determine whether to continue or terminate her pregnancy. The court, however, denied appellant's request for injunctive relief. And it is exactly the absence of an injunction against future prosecutions of doctors who perform abortions which has caused the irreparable injuries to women seeking abortions. In Texas, the woman is the victim. Without legal, medically safe abortions available, women are resorting to illegal abortions with risks of death and all the side effects. Severe infections, permanent sterility, all of the complications. In our state,
the microphone won't be effective if it's covered over.
Excuse me, Your Honor. Thank you. Pregnancy disrupts a woman's body. It disrupts her education. And it often disrupts her entire family life. And we feel that insofar as there are any rights that are fundamental, pregnancy is a matter of such fundamental and basic concern to the woman involved that she should be allowed to make the choice between continuing and terminating her pregnancy.
Mrs. Weddington, I trust you're going to get to what provisions of the Constitution you're relying on?
Your Honor, as I'm sure you are aware, the lower court held that a woman's right to decide whether or not to continue her pregnancy rested upon the Ninth Amendment, which grants to the people those rights not specifically granted to the government. I think the 14th Amendment is an equally appropriate place under the rights of the people to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
You're relying in this branch of your argument simply on the due process clause of the 14th Amendment?
We had originally brought the suit alleging both the Due Process Clause, the Equal Protection Clause, the Ninth Amendment, and a variety of others. Now, since...
And anything else that seems appropriate.
Yes.
Do you make any distinction based upon what period of pregnancy the abortion is performed?
No, sir. I feel the question of a time limit is not strictly before the court.
Well, what is your constitutional position, though?
It is our position that the freedom involved is that of a woman to decide whether or not to continue her pregnancy. Obviously, I have a much more difficult time in saying the state has no interest in late pregnancy.
Why? Why is that?
I feel it's more the emotional response to a late pregnancy rather than any constitutional...
Emotional response by whom?
I guess by persons considering the issues outside of the legal context, but I think that as far as the state...
Do you or don't you say that the constitutional...
I would say that the constitutional right...
Right you insist on...
Yes, sir.
...reaches up to the time of birth or what?
The Constitution, as I read it, attaches protection to the person at the time of birth. Those persons born are citizens. The Constitution, as I see it, gives protection to people after birth.
Does Texas law give rights to unborn children in the areas of trusts, estates, wills, or...
No, Your Honor. Only if they are born alive.
What about the unborn child that is, as a result of an accident, killed, or... whatever word you want to use for it. What about the mother recovering for the death of her child, or for the, whatever you want to call it?
Only for her injury.
But nothing in regard to the child?
No, Your Honor. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Weddington. Mr. Floyd?
Mr. Chief Justice, and may it please the court. Before I proceed to the original issue of this case, the propriety of denying injunctive relief, I would like to bring to the court's attention the grave matter of standing. The record that came up to this court contains the petition of Jane Roe, an alias affidavit. She alleges that she was pregnant on April the 20th, 1970, which is some 21 months ago. Now, I think that it has been recognized by appellant's counsel that she is no longer pregnant. A unique situation arises. Is her action now moot? Of course, if moot, there is no case or controversy.
It was a class action, wasn't it?
It was a class action.
Well, surely you would. I suppose we could almost take judicial notice of the fact that there are, at any given time, unmarried pregnant females in the state of Texas, couldn't we?
Yes, Your Honor. But it would appear that in order for a class action to continue, if there be one to begin with, one plaintiff must remain, or some representative of the class, because...
How would you suggest, if you're right, that any pregnant female in the state of Texas could ever get any judicial consideration of this constitutional claim?
Your Honor, I don't believe it can be done. There are situations in which, as the court knows, no remedy is provided. Now, I think she makes her choice prior to the time she becomes pregnant. That is the time for choice.
Maybe she makes that choice when she decides to live in Texas.
May I proceed? There's no restriction on moving, you know.
Mr. Floyd, what is Texas' interest in this statute?
Mr. Justice, in the Thompson case, which has already been cited, Thompson versus State, the Court of Criminal Appeals held that the state had a compelling interest in the protection of fetal life, They recognized the humanness of the embryo, or the fetus.
In the first few weeks of pregnancy?
Sir?
In the first few weeks of pregnancy?
At any time, Mr. Justice, we make no distinction.
You make no distinction whether there's life there or not?
We say there is life from the moment of impregnation.
Well, do you have any scientific data to back that up?
Well, we begin, Mr. Justice, in our brief with the development of the human embryo, carrying it through to the development of the fetus from about 7 to 9 days after conception.
Well, what about 6 days?
We don't know.
But the statute goes all the way back to 1 hour.
I don't,
Mr. Justice, there are unanswerable questions in this field.
I appreciate it. I withdraw the question.
Thank you. That's really when the soul comes into the unborn. If a person believes in a soul, I don't know. As for the constitutional right the appellant speaks of to choose whether or not to abort a child, the freedom over one's body is not absolute. The use of illicit drugs, the indecent exposure legislation, and as Mr. Justice Mr. Goldberg stated in the Griswold case, the laws against adultery and fornication are constitutional beyond doubt. We don't disagree with the appellant that a woman has a choice, but we feel that that choice is the woman's prior to the time she becomes pregnant. This is the time for choice.
Texas doesn't grant any exception in the case of rape if pregnancy resulted from rape, does it?
There's nothing in our statute about that.
And such a woman wouldn't have had a choice, would she?
We feel that these are matters of policy and should be properly addressed by the state legislature. We think a consideration should be given to the unborn. Thank you, Your Honors.
Thank you, Mr. Floyd. Mrs. Weddington. The case is submitted.
You'd probably want cake for dinner, wouldn't you? You and Sandy probably split one.
What is he talking about?
I don't know.
She did good.
She did good if we won.
Hello?
Ellen, it's Sarah.
Well, hey.
Hi. Well, I got through today, all right.
Did I ever thank you?
Because in case I didn't, I just
wanted to say thank you.
They interrupted me every third sentence.
You kept coming right on back? You ever happy with the presentation?
No.
There you go. Would you have handled it any different to do it over?
No. They already had their minds made up.
Jay, why don't we wait for the vote?
I wonder if there's ever been an oral argument dazzling enough to pull them around.
It's the times.
Would Clarence Darrow have pulled them around?
Jay, why don't we wait for the vote?
Times change.
Huh. They just legalized abortion.
Where does it say?
Ruled Monday that American women have the right to have medical abortions during the first 6 months of pregnancy. Abortions until the end of the first trimester are to be left to the medical judgment of the doctor. At least it'll be doctors doing them now.
Yeah.
In what is being described as a compromise ruling, abortions during the second trimester may only be regulated to protect the health of the mother, but they may be prohibited in the last 3 months of pregnancy to safeguard the fetus. The case decided today, Roe versus Wade.
Why? Why didn't they decide this 2 years ago? Then I wouldn't have had to go through everything.
You mean you would have done that?
Yeah, I would. Is that awful?
No. Why would I think that?
I want to tell you something, okay? You see where it says Roe versus Wade?
Yeah.
That's me. I'm Jane Roe.
Quit it.
No, Jane Roe versus Henry Wade, District Attorney of Dallas County. I am Jane Roe.
My hell. Are you serious?
Thank you.
Why didn't you ever tell me?
I was afraid of what you might say.
You ought to be proud, girl. You really started something. You really did something.
Did I?
You want a beer?
Yeah, sure. Go for one.